we met at the Wyzetta Country Club. I had been working there for several years and she was a new server.
After I had my interview there, it was really comical that I ran into him and he was dressed like how all the servers are dressed, and he tried to tell me he was a manager and introduced himself.
And at the time I was starting to get into management, so I like to remember it as I, you know, was somewhat responsible for hiring her on.
And right then and there, we shared our first laugh of many. When I questioned how he could be a manager when dressed like all the other servers, thinking he was just messing around with me. From that moment on, our connection was undeniable.
It was so comfortable to be around her, and just right from the very beginning, I just, you know, had a connection with her.
I think I knew it was true love when all I did was talk about him and think, when's the next time I get to see him? It's amazing how many times you can work one person's name into a conversation when talking to your friends and family. I even remember playing tennis just to have an excuse to hang out with him. I'd also pick up shifts at the club if Matt were working those days. I knew early on there was something different about him and I couldn't stay away. I guess you could say Matt was contagious.
Started off and going on dates and just knowing myself, like I just wanted to wow her and I wanted to amaze her, and I took her home to Tennessee for the first time. I mean, that was, you know, a big deal in my mind.
And knowing I just couldn't live without him, and whenever he was gone, I would think about him and constantly missed him, and it was really assuring to know all of my friends liked him and my family liked him, that everywhere around me I was getting positive feedback regarding him, that I knew he was a keeper.
Oh, the next 5 years, well, I know what she would say. She would say kids, dog, more kids, things like that.
I would envision us to have some children on the way, starting a family, getting a white lab, of course, and doing the Minnesota traditional family structured life.
But, you know, I'm looking forward to enjoying, you know, the first couple years anyway as a married couple. I'd like to travel. I'd like to show her a couple other places that I've been in the world that I'd like to share with her.
What I love best about Matt is that he has the largest heart I've ever known a man to have. He is the absolute best to be around and makes me strive to be a better person every day. My favorite thing about Matt is that no matter what kind of day I'm having, he can make me laugh about the smallest things, and those are the memories that last the longest.
She is the most driven person I've ever met. She's extremely friendly and outgoing, and she's such an accomplished teacher. Honestly, to simply put, I mean, she's gorgeous. She is absolutely the most beautiful person I've ever met.
It takes a one little I'm sorry and he's over it. For me, it's sometimes a grudge and it takes a little bit of time. For him, it's sorry and like it never happened. So I really love how caring he is and passionate and just the ability to forgive.
What does she admire most about me? Well, what she would probably say is that I'm a passionate person, that I'm a caring person.
What Matt loves best about me is probably my quirky personality and how much I love to laugh. I really think he appreciates how much of a planner I am too, even though I doubt he'd ever admit that. With me, there's always a plan and something to do, but I wouldn't want to do any of it without him by my side. Matt's definitely my other half, my better half. You said with such honest feeling, but what'd you really mean when you said that I'm your man? Well,